Hello, my name is Shang-Chi. I'm a eunuch in the Emperor's Royal Palace. When he was younger, my sole purpose was to take care of him, make sure he was happy, and guard him and keep him inside the palace walls. As he grew older, the need for me lessened, and I was only there to keep him safe and make sure he didn't leave the palace walls. As a eunuch, I am castrated, and being castrated means my genitals were cut off. This is to keep the women safe inside the palace, to make sure me and the eunuchs don't take advantage of the women. As soon as the emperor fell from power, I was kicked out of the emperor's guards and the emperor's palace, and I was made to wander the streets for the rest of my life. I was never accepted by the general public, and I was spit on and made fun of for my disfigurement and change in voice. All right, cut.
My name is Puyi, and I'm the last emperor of the Qin Dynasty of China. I was born on February 7, 1906 in Beijing. When my uncle died in 1908, I inherited the throne at the mere age of 2. I ruled until February 12, 1912, when the Xinhai Revolution occurred. The Xinhai Revolution was the ultimate act to destroy China's imperial dynasty and create the Republic of China. At the end of World War II, I was imprisoned by the Russians. They returned me to China, where I was tried as a war criminal and sentenced to prison for about 10 years. In 1959, I was pardoned and I returned to Beijing, where I worked in a botanical garden as an assistant gardener. I later became a researcher at an institute of literature and history. Unfortunately, at the age of 61, I was diagnosed with kidney cancer and died.
My name is Cixi, and I am an empress. I am also the grandmother of Puyi. I was born in 1865 in a normal house, but I was the oldest child and I felt neglected. My family ignored me, and I never felt like I belonged. But at the age of 18, I got to live in the Forbidden City, which gave me the chance to escape my family life. As I got older, the current emperor, Emperor Xianfeng, named me one of his wives, and I was the only woman to bear him a son. He died soon after that, but his son was put on the throne. But eventually, I took over and reigned as the Empress of China. I'm a very powerful empress, but sometimes I can be greedy. I spend a lot of money on jewelry, but I'm the empress. I should have the best. I'm also very conservative-minded. I don't think China should be changing like the rest of the world. We're perfect just the way we are. During my reign, however, my son went crazy. By the age of 15, he was drinking heavily, and he married a woman at age 16. However, he contracted smallpox and died, and then his wife killed herself. I think I might have driven her to it. Now that I'm getting older, my grandson, Puyi, will most likely have to take over the throne. Let's hope he's as good of an emperor as I was an empress.